do some Meatless Monday activity. Check this out. Beet burgers with Chef Devin. Hey. I could give you this. You can bring your whites. So I want to know where the idea for this came from, because most people, you know, people who like beets love beets.
But I'm one of those people.
You're one of those people.
Absolutely.
So good for you.
So good for you.
Most people would not think of putting it into a burger patty.
I think one of the reasons why it's such a good alternative for a beef burger is that it kind of has a similar color.
Right.
So it kind of looks like you're eating meat at the same time, and you mentioned that beets are so good for you.
Yeah, they are.
High in vitamins and minerals. Folic acid, beta carotene, there's just magnesium fiber, there's so much goodness going on in them. So to make this beet burger, super simple, all these ingredients here you can put into this bowl.
Okay.
So we have the shredded beets.
And do you want me to do that now?
Yeah, go for it.
All of them?
All of it, yeah.
All of it, okay.
When you grate the beets, you want to squeeze out the majority of the moisture,
right?
Because they'll fall apart when you cook them, but not all of the moisture, right?
Okay.
We're gonna add in some feta, the eggs are gonna go in there too. Notice how I'm putting on the gloves.
Yes, I have
your
noticed.
Nails,
so you're going to do this. Is this coconut oil?
Your nails
oil?
Are always so pretty. That is coconut oil.
Very nice.
Healthy.
Love
gives
that
a nice
ingredient.
Little flavor. And then just give a little sprinkle of the oats.
Oh,
not
yeah.
all of
okay.
it, maybe
all
like,
right.
you know. Yep.
That's just going to help bind it all together,
exactly.
right?
Exactly. The egg and between the oats and the egg, that'll be your binder. Add some olive oil as well.
Oh, yeah. Okay.
Which is in that bottle.
How's that,
Chef? We'll go a little bit more.
A little bit more?
Yeah, it's just olive oil. It's not butter like I usually use, so.
Look at
the
all of the
coming.
Ingredients, though. Everything I put in was good. What was in there?
That was feta.
That was feta. See,
yep.
it's all good for
Canadian
you.
Canadian feta.
Maybe
you can use Greek feta
Maybe
if you like.
Maybe a little bit more. There, okay, that's good.
Oh my goodness.
I like olive oil.
Yeah, and then we're
good
gonna
for
give
the skin and the hair.
Absolutely,
and, the nails.
And we're just gonna give that a little bit of a mix.
Okay.
The reason why you put the oats in is so it absorbs a lot of that moisture and helps it bind, like we just mentioned.
Got
but
it.
You have to let this sit for about half an hour to an hour. Sometimes you can even leave it overnight if you want,
okay.
because that'll let it really sit together. And then once it sets, you'll have a mixture similar to what I have here in my hand. And it's kind of a little bit messy, but I'll just do it over here, and you'll see how it's binding together really nicely.
That looks great.
Yep.
So a lot of people would think a beet, it seems, it's such a water vegetable. How is that all gonna stick together?
Yeah, well,
but as you mentioned, taking the moisture out of it is a big part of it.
That is a very big part of it.
And then letting it sit,
yeah,
the ingredients sit together for a while, right?
And if you're one of those people that likes beets, then I think like they're just so delicious for me.
Look at that.
They're just the natural sweetness. They're so high in that beautiful, natural sugar. I just love them. I can't get enough of beets, which is why I came up with these couple recipes today.
Well, this is what people use for detox, right?
Exactly.
They have
yep.
beet juice, so
yep.
it's very good. The kidneys, the liver, all of that.
Exactly.
Stuff.
It acts like a tonic for your liver. It purifies
right.
your blood. Super, super good
it's
for
huge.
You.
It's a walking nutritionist. What I like about that, though, is that most chefs don't necessarily care about nutrition. I
no,
like that you know.
Absolutely.
That's good.
I love it.
That's really good.
They're good for it's good for pregnant women. It's good for
yes,
mental
it
health.
Is.
Beets are amazing. So with our basil,
Dr. Chef Devin.
My initials are DR, but that's the next thing. Okay? So basil, we'll just roll it up, and we're gonna add some basil into this. Very important when you're cutting at home that you curl in your fingers. Now I do a lot of knife
yeah.
skills on my segments, but I don't actually say how. So okay, so we're gonna hold onto the knife
okay.
where you just kind of call it choking up, and you want to kind of I always say like I'm making like a claw,
like a little claw,
just so your the point of your finger is tucked in, and
All
if
right.
it's tucked in like this, and the knife braces against it, your fingers are never exposed. Okay.
So let me try it. Do you trust me?
I think okay. they told me not to do this.
Yeah, they probably did.
They probably did.
The producers were all like, don't let her do it! So I'm gonna try.
Yep.
So I got the claw
so your
going
finger,
on.
Yeah, so the
like
tips
that.
Of your fingers hold whatever you're using.
Go,
and,
stay.
And then the blade.
How do you do it so fast?
Well, it's kind of like a rocking motion.
Like that a little bit?
We're gonna have to practice.
But I kept my fingers, everyone, yeah.
But at least your fingers are safe.
Yes, they
so
are.
So I'm coming across with this knife.
Nails.
So basil is going to go in there. Basil and beets go really, really well together, right?
Okay.
You might notice that on the burger, I have some avocado.
Yeah.
A cool thing with the avocado is if you make some slices of it, just chop it up really nice like this. And if you take your knife, you might have seen this with garlic, how you can shave garlic, but you can do the same thing with your knife.
Oh.
And essentially, like nature's butter, there's
yeah.
your guacamole, just like this.
That's cool.
This just goes right onto your bun and you spread it just like butter.
Yeah.
So it's another neat trick. It's like, you know, instant guacamole.
I've never seen it done like that, but so good for you, those good healthy fats, right?
Exactly, exactly.
Really nice. Okay, so we've got the beet burger. Here's the thing that that is sort of surprising. What's the yellow thing on there? Is that mango?
That's mango. So avocado, mango,
does anyone
beets.
Else find that weird? Okay, good. One person in the audience is like, yes. But I bet you that taste combination is amazing. I wouldn't think of putting a mango on my beet burger.
I love mango. Yeah. It's sweet, it's sour. This one is not super, super ripe. Mm-hmm. Oh, another cool trick with mango. But yeah, okay. The combination of flavors is amazing. Okay. My cutting board's getting a bit messy, so if you're watching at home, don't
you
do
would
this.
Clean it by this point.
Yes, absolutely. This is no bueno, okay? All right, so with your mango, let's take the lime, for example.
Okay.
So the mango has already been sliced, but whenever you're working with a nice round object, just take a slice out of it so it lays flat. So yeah. With the mango, for example, if I'm rolling it around like this, I can always straighten out that edge so it lays flat. This is much safer when you go to cut, and that's how I get these really nice slices on the mango. So
nice.
I can put it on its side, and then from here you can get really, you know, it's not
wow.
rolling around anywhere, so that's really
okay.
important.
Okay, that's like you're chopping like you're a mandolin there.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's amazing.
But the beet burger is phenomenal. Another thing too, you might notice I have different types of beets here as well.
Yeah, which one did you like or which one did you use?
So red for the color. Red is a beautiful thing, but you can also mix it. I've done it where I've mixed it so you get specks of orange through it or specks of that candy cane stripe through it.
Yeah.
Like, have fun with it. This is just the basic beet burger, but take it and run with it.
Very cool. And you took it and you ran with it and it looks amazing.
Yes.
Chef Devin, the recipe is online, cityline.ca. Let's go to break. Got more coming up.